Yeah, this one good. Okay. Our next comic would like to try some of that delicious cold ash everyone has been talking about.
Okay, I just want to
electrical waste.
You know what's not a great city? Toledo, Ohio. That's a garbage town. That's right. That's where I'm from. So, you know, there's a little soft spot for it, but it's embarrassing to say that you're from Toledo. But I say it all the time, I'm from Toledo. But it's embarrassing because people think we're stupid. Remember that movie when Denzel has to chase down that runaway train because some fat idiot was too busy eating a candy bar to do his job? Smells terrible. It's Detroit's butthole. When you enter Toledo, there's a sign that says, Toledo, gross and stinky, like a urinal. How come every time I'm at a urinal, it's gotta be a competition? It's a literal pissing match. It is. Words are not spoken, but we all know, dudes, we're trying to pee longer than the guy next to us. These matches. Not afraid to say it. My secret? Okay, I'll share it with you. You see, I hold it. I hold it as long as possible whenever I'm in public until I'm absolutely at risk of wetting my pants. Recently, I'm in a crowded men's room, right? I'm in the back of the line. I'm in so much pain, I can't stand it, but I'm gonna win. I'm gonna tell you that, I'm gonna win. But all of a sudden, dude walks in, ignores the line completely. He goes right to the next available urinal. Now, first guy in line, he's mad. He's about to say something to this dude. This is going to be a fight. But before he can, dude drops his pants and underwear all the way down. Starts going. So line guy stands down. He don't say a word because clearly there's something wrong with this dude. Or is there? I'm in the back of the line dying like a chump. This dude's a genius. All you gotta do to get to the front of the line is drop your pants. It works everywhere. Boom! Front of the line. What's the matter, man? Wrong class? I go to a lot of parent-teacher conferences as the parent. I got kids. My kids are jerks. What are you gonna do? I'm just glad that from Halloween till Christmas, Santa's watching. Means I don't have to. It's a little break. It's a nice break. I just don't understand why nobody's ever invented a summer Santa for another break. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're in luck, because I give to you the birthday giant. That's right, the birthday giant. The birthday giant is a big, scary giant. He lives in the sky. If you're good, he brings you toys. But if you're bad, he destroys all the toys you have. works. Let me tell you, my kids were scared of the birthday giant. They behaved. It was awesome. And then my wife says,
"No, honey, Dad, just kidding. There's no such thing as the birthday giant."
My wife's a jerk. My house is filled with jerks. Kind of like Facebook. That is filled with jerks. Can you believe that? My favorite thing on Facebook, though, is old people. They're hilarious. They don't get it. I posted a picture of a brand new chair that I got. I was really excited. Posted to Facebook. First comment was from my Aunt Mabel. In all caps, she writes, "Dear Joey, I love the chair. It looks very comfy. I hope you're going to church."
Joe Upsinger.